first time when we started to speak about this recording, I actually had a big package of scores. It was 27 scores from Milanos and from Donizetti only, many operas that I've never heard, never have seen in my life. I didn't find any recordings. And for me, it was important not just to have a sentimental pieces, you know, where you just listen to beautiful melody, but also have some characteristic challenge, you know, not only just sad, but also a little bit more naughty, more nasty. Very, very difficult repertoire to sing for the voice. You need to have a superb control of your breathing, of intonation, you know. You have to be able in a short time to give a maximum emotion without really, you know, passionate portamento, also passionate screams sometimes, as you find in a Puccini.
Interpretation is the most important, and what can make the difference between a very good singer and a top-class singer. And Elina has all these qualities, and she's a real interpreter. When she's singing Elisabetta, Queen of England, she is Elisabetta. When she sings Nelly in or Romeo, she is Romeo, and so on. That, I think, is at the end, in the end, is the most important.
This Bellini Dopo l'Oscura is probably one of the typical bel canto crying arias, as I would say, and I think that people, or I hope people, will be really very touched. And the first time I heard it was, for me, you know, you just, as I say, you just turn off the lights and you don't need anything else.